We're going over all the details of the auto start in Xmonad, and we have skipped one thing that I would like to treat separately, and that's Compton. And Compton has a configuration file in your home, in your Xmonad, in scripts, in Compton conf. So if you ever want to change this, it is here. Now, Compton is responsible for three major things. That's the transparency, the shading, and the shadow. And you will find these three divisions somewhere in here. Okay, so shadow is in here, opacity is in here, and the fading is in here. But most of these things have now been, well, not used because of the fact that we are using a tiling window manager. What's the sense to have a shadow in here at these sides? It's gonna be a little bit ugly. We've tried, we've looked at it and said, no, we won't do it. But the settings are in here. Now, what's important for you to know is that this thing that I'm explaining now doesn't matter if it's on Xmonad, OpenBox uses Compton, i3 uses Compton, BSPWM uses Compton, and any future and all desktops that use Compton, you need to figure out your settings that work for you, that you like to see. And then you can reuse your own Compton conf on any of these desktops. But this line 89, it has a reason why it's all at the top. It always depends on hardware. That's a very typical expression for Linux. It all depends on your hardware. At this point in time, we have as backend XRender, and could be better for you if you change the backend to GLX. So it's ready for you to try out. The only thing you need to do is change this line, that line, save, reboot, and Compton will kick in and it will act as if the backend is GLX. See if that improves things, and if that doesn't improve, you need to go further and further into detail. And here you have all the settings of GLX, and down the other part you have all the XRender elements. So lots of things to check out. Most of the time everything will just work because we've tested and tested and tested in all these desktops. So this is for us a setting that works, but it might be interesting for you to know that this is still something you can edit if you have issues. So that's Compton.com for you. It's launched up here, and you can change the Compton conf. You can make a new one, name this guy Eric, and then maybe that's a good thing to just show you. And I say, okay, I'm gonna experiment with this Compton conf. Maybe it's gonna be an improvement for me. You go to Xmonad, you go to the scripts, and Control C, Control V, and you start improving and testing. So you have a copy, and then you load or restart with using the Compton-Eric, like here. So that's something you could do if you run into issues with Compton. All right, enjoy. Let's kill this so I can get to the closing here. Save.